everyone.
Hello, good evening. I'm scared
oh
too.
My guys, just you. Oh my goodness. Yes. This is unbelievable.
No, it can be. It can be.
And you know what? Today I cannot open my camera because it's not working. It looks like red, so I won't be able to open it. Hopefully we have more people because we need to practice.
Yes, of course. But I was scared too because what happened? I don't know what happened. Maybe I made a mistake. I don't know.
Maybe I'm not in the right place. I know how it feels.
Okay.
I'm gonna send them a WhatsApp message right now. Okay, let me see. Oh my god. Because I don't know why they are not here. Ellos siempre son super puntuales.
Yes. Ah. Pedrina is arriving right now. Good evening, Pedrina.
Good evening, Pedrina.
Hello. Hello.
We are alone.
Solo dos habemos. Solo usted y yo.
Tres, y a mí no me cuenta.
Ah, ¿cómo no? Es que no la...
Estudiante.
Estudiante. Okay. Okay, let's wait for two more. For one or two minutes, a las 8:04, si no ha venido nadie, yo empiezo con ustedes. ¿Qué les parece?
Sí, está bien.
Está bien.
Bueno, okay. Hay otro más.
Strange night.
Está funcionando el mensaje de WhatsApp. Hi, Amilka.
Hi.
Hi.
Okay, one more minute and we start.
Hola.
Okay, now it's time to start. I have more people now. This is nice. Now, I was telling Carmen at the beginning of the call, I would say this in Spanish, este día, mi laptop estará gana porque viernes, entonces no quiere encender la cámara. So, I am going to work like this with you today. Okay, voy a trabajar con la cámara apagada. Ustedes tienen que mantener su cámara encendidita, por favor. Yo sí lo veo a ustedes no me ven a mí. Miren que lo puedo, ¿verdad? pero vamos a trabajar de esa forma, ¿ok? Now, let's start with today's class. Yesterday we were working with have to, and today we're going to do also a review with many things that we are going to use during the week, okay? Now, let me show you. Tengo un montón de ejercicios, chicos, que quiero que trabajemos para ir avanzando un poco más, okay? Let's start. Yesterday we were working with this exercise, right? Ustedes me deben oraciones de ayer. You owe me sentences from yesterday's class. And I would like you to tell me. I want you to tell me about the sentences that you owe me. Right? Let's start with here. Yesterday we said that you were going to tell me sentences that contain when, what time, and where. Right? So, tell me about those sentences. When, what time, and where. So let's start here. Celia, what do you have? Esta era su tarea. ¿De qué? No la hice. ¿Por qué a mí? Okay.
Sí, ¿por qué a mí?
¿Por qué?
I need to go and play soccer Sunday at 8 a.m.
Okay, I need
to go play soccer Sunday at 8 a.m. Mm-hmm.
I need to go play soccer on Sunday at 9 a.m.
Yes.
Okay. I need to go to play soccer. To play soccer on Sunday at 9 a.m. Very good. Look at the question, and I am going to ask you right now based on this sentence. Azalia. Hello, Azalia. Azalia, tell me when. When is she going to play soccer? Azalea is not here. Hey, Emerson, when is she going to play soccer? Hello, Azalea.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening.
Sorry, teacher.
Okay, let me ask you here. Look at the sentence. It says, I need to go to play soccer on Sunday. Esa es de Celia. Con esto yo le voy a preguntar a ustedes. When does she need to go to play soccer?
She needs on Sunday.
Okay. She needs to go to play soccer on Sunday. Very good. What time does she need to go to play soccer, Azalia?
She at 9 a.m.
At 9 a.m. Or she needs to go at 9 a.m. Okay, very good.
Yes.
Now, do we have here the answer for where?
Celia? No, teacher.
No, we don't. So I need to go to play soccer at the park on Sunday at 9 a.m. Okay, on Sunday at 9 a.m. Very good. So, tell me another sentence so we can continue working. Tell me another sentence. ¿Quién tiene otro ejemplo? Thank you, Celia. Thank you, Emerson, Carmen, and Azalia.
Teacher.
Yes. Yes, yes.
I need.
Yes.
I need. I need to go to the doctor tomorrow at the 8 a.m.
I need to go to the doctor tomorrow
at A.M.
8 a.m. 8 a.m. Repeat. 8 a.m. A.M. Okay.
No sé si.
Concepción. When does she need to go to the doctor?
She go to the doctor tomorrow.
Tomorrow, very good. She needs to go to the doctor tomorrow. Very good. What time does she need to go to the doctor, Leida? What time does she need to go to the doctor? What time?
At 8 a.m.
That's perfect, Leida. And Daniela Milcar. Where does she need to go? Where does she need to go?
Voy
a poner mute, Pedrina, porque me asustó.
Sí, ahorita.
Okay. Where does she need to go? Daniela Milton. Okay, Sandra Gladys. Okay, Amilcar, go.
Hi. Good evening.
Good evening. Amilcar, do you have the answer?
Hola.
Hola. ¿Qué tal? ¿Cómo está? Look at the sentence and tell me where does she need to go?
To the doctor.
To the doctor. Very good. To the doctor. Excellent. She needs to go to the doctor. Very well. Okay. She needs to go to the doctor. Now, do we understand these sentences? ¿Entendemos estas oraciones? ¿Sí? ¿Entendemos qué significa when, what time, and where? Do we understand that? Okay, I will take that as a yes. Ese silencio total lo tomaré como un sí. Veamos qué pasa con los siguientes ejercicios, okay? We go with the next exercise here. It says, now write activities you have to do or need to do in your job. No, let's do this one. Look at this exercise. Let me put it bigger so you can see it. Vamos a poner más grandecito. We have 15 sentences. In these 15 sentences that we're going to practice, because I want you to practice, and what we're going to do is to practice have to. Okay? Have to. That's what we're going to practice. These sentences, this is general English. Okay? Vocabulario general de inglés. Okay? And it says number one. Number one. Today is a holiday. Today is a holiday. And then I have the first answer here that I need to put, right? Do you know what a holiday is? ¿Saben qué es un holiday?
Yes, it's a day off.
Es un feriado, exactly. Exactly. For example, we're going to have holidays on my birthday. That's 19th, okay? And again, abril, ya nos toca, ya casi, right? We're going to have holidays. So we say today is a holiday. What could be the answer here? Yes, Carmen?
Sorry about the holidays. I have a question. We will to have classes on this holiday.
We don't know. Usually we don't. We don't. But they haven't said anything yet. So
okay.
Tal vez tengamos. Viernes Santo en clases. Penitencia.
El traje de baño va a estar recibiendo la clase, teacher.
Ustedes allá en el Tunco y aquí en la casa. Okay. Okay. So it says here today is a holiday. And what would be the form of have to? Remember the form of have to? It can be have to, has to, don't have to, doesn't have to. Okay, so what can we put here?
Today, I don't have to go.
I don't have to go to work. Very good. I don't have to go to work. That's the answer I am going to put here on number one. I don't have to go to work. Okay, that's the first one. And that is in the same way we're going to do the other ones. Okay. We're going to do the other ones in the same way. Let's do number two, okay? Le voy a dejar dos hechas, vamos a ver cómo nos va. And let me ask you here. Let me see. Aquí no veo con sueño. Okay, no, I'm kidding, estoy bromeando. Let me see.
Teacher.
Yes, Sandra.
Pero ahí también puede quedar, tengo que trabajar. Ay.
Yes.
Yes. Pero puede decir.
Pero sería, sí se puede. Pero es como, estamos hablando de un caso más general. Lo que usted está diciendo es una excepción. Que dice, es un feriado y I have to work. I have to go to work. Pero como aquí vamos a trabajar con lo estándar, con lo generalizado. Si es un día feriado, no vamos a trabajar. Se supone, ¿verdad?
No, vamos a estudiar.
We're not, I don't have to study. I don't have to teach English. Okay. So in number two, we have it's a vacation, exactly. In number two, we have a question. It says here, your sister go to school today? It's a question. Now let me ask you, your sister, what subject pronoun is your sister?
I'm sorry, she.
She, is a she, okay, very good. And with she, what is the auxiliary we use with she, Angie?
Does,
excellent job. If we use does, how can we make the question here? It's a question. We know that here we need to put does, right, at the beginning. That. And then we need to use the form of have to. What are we going to do? What is next? Does your sister?
Have to.
Have to. Very good. Does your sister have to go to school today? Does your sister have to go to school today? Yes, she has to go.
It's have to.
Why is have to? No se preocupe, ya le va a contestar mi amiga Celia porque es have to and no has to. Ella sabe, ayer me dijo.
Have to for...
Porque ella me está preguntando por qué no utilicé has to. Aquí, si estoy hablando de your sister. ¿Por qué no utilice has to, sino que utilice have to? Mi respuesta está buena, se lo puedo asegurar.
Porque ya lleva el auxiliar does.
Exactly, very good. It's already, you're using already the auxiliary, and you're using does. It says, does your sister have to go to school today? Entonces, como ya utilizamos en el does, ya no tenemos que utilizarlo en el verbo. Siempre que utilizamos does en una pregunta o en una oración afirmativa o una respuesta corta, ya nuestro verbo ya no tiene que ir conjugado con la regla de la ex. ¿Ok? Concepción. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Now, I need you or I want you to please take a screenshot of this. Take a screenshot of this. And once you have taken a screenshot, let me know so you can work. Dígame cuando termine.
Teacher, and when you are talking about the negative form, you also didn't use the has in she. For example,
exactly.
She doesn't have.
She doesn't have, exactly. Exactly. She okay. doesn't
for
have.
For question and for negative statement.
Exactly. Okay, did you take a screenshot? ¿Tomaron el screenshot? Did you take the screenshot? Hello? Hi, how are you?
Yes.
Okay. Now I am going to call the attendance right now with all of you. Right, just give me one moment. We're going to work in pairs right now for this exercise. Y para que lo hagamos más fácil, porque yo sé que son 15, vamos a dividirnos el trabajo, okay? Aunque estemos en grupos, right? Give me one second. Vamos, por ejemplo, si estoy trabajando con Carmen y con Angie, entre las tres nos vamos a dividir el trabajo que vamos a tener, okay? That's what we're going to do. Let me start with the attendance and then we move to the groups. Ana Gabriela Córdoba de Samayoa. No. Ángela de Jesús Santa María Juárez.
Present, teacher.
Azalia Melanie Guardado Portillo.
Present, teacher.
Good. Carmen Lizeth Hernández Escobar.
Present.
Thank you. Celia Jasmine Castro de Chévez.
Present.
Very well. Daniela Milker Sandoval Avilés.
Present.
Very good. Emerson Javier Rivera Rojas.
Present.
Excellent job. José Alfonso Palma. Juan Josué Hernández Hernández. Leida Susana Sorto Cuadra.
Present.
Very good. Luis Armando Ventura Campos. María Concepción Esterón Jovel.
Present.
Pedrina Iliana Gómez Ortega.
Present, teacher.
Ricardo Alexis Fuentes Rodríguez. Ricardo Gabriel Berenga Ventura. Roxana Yanira Mejíbar Escobar. Sandra Gladys Méndez de Barahona.
Presente, teacher.
Jennifer Abidaí López Escoto. Okay. Now we are going to continue working here with the different activity, okay? Now, remember that we are going to work in pairs. We have 12 participants right now. Tenemos 12 participantes. De los 12 vamos a trabajar en grupos de 3. We are going to divide the sentences, okay? So, for example, if I'm working with Carmen and Angie, Carmen can work question 3, 4, 5, Angie 6, 7, 8, and I can work the others, okay? Vamos a dividirnos el trabajo para que nos salga más fácil, okay? That's what we're going to do. After you have finished, you are going to correct the sentences. El hecho que yo haya hecho las oraciones no significa que van a ser correctas. Angie y Carmen tienen que revisar mis oraciones y copiarlas para ver si yo las hice bien. ¿Ok? That's what we're going to do. We're going to do writing and correction. ¿Ok? Vamos a hacer escritura y corrección. Let's go ahead and start. ¿Se entiende lo que vamos a trabajar?
Yes, teacher.
Yes? Ok, very well. Let's start.
No la veo, teacher.
No me va a ver.
Pero hace falta, teacher.
No me va a ver este día. Maybe on Monday.
Qué mal.
Maybe on Monday. Okay, let's start. We're going to have 5 minutes to complete this. 5 minuticos.
Qué poquito.
Let's go.
Aquí. Ah, okay.
Este, chicas, yo voy por las 6, pero solo copiándolas, ni la he respondido.
¿La ven?
¿Las 6?
Sí, sí la veo.
Ah, perdón, sí.
Ok, las repartimos entonces.
Este, yo he copiado hasta las 6, pero no la he... Porque estoy copiando.
Ah, pues si quiere agarre de 1 a las 5 usted y yo de las 6 a las 10 y a Salia de las 11 a las 15, no sé si les parece.
Sí, yo ahorita estoy en las 6, de la 1 a las 6 puedo hacer hasta la 9, podría ser. O la...
Como las tiene que contestar, ahorita las ha copiado.
Ajá, pero como ajá. 2 las hizo la teacher.
Así ¿de qué que... galán? Ajá.
Ahí está. No la había visto. Bueno, es que ni la veo, de hecho.
No me va a ver, les digo.
Qué lástima. Hace falta verla, teacher.
My camera doesn't work. Mi cámara no sirve.
Qué mal. Ay, la save, to the story.
Do you have questions? No questions? Okay, let me go with another group. Do you have questions, guys? ¿Preguntas?
No, teacher, we are working. Amilcar from 1 to 5, Verena from 6 to 10, and I for from 11 to 15.
Okay, perfect. Hello, is
my teacher.
I think Alexis was here. Pensé que aquí más de Alexis. Permítame, ya regreso. Sí. Hello, Alexis.
Hello.
Okay, we are working on an exercise, Alexis. Can you work or you're still driving?
Voy saliendo del trabajo, teacher. Aquí voy en la moto, solo voy a escuchar.
Ok, entonces quédese de oyente, no se preocupe.
Hola, no le escuché.
Quédese de oyente, le digo, no se preocupe.
Pero no tengo nada que hacer.
Buenas noches, Dios de Ricardo.
Ya terminó Emerson.
La última estoy resolviendo ahorita yo.
Ricardo, we're working on this exercise. I'm going to show you right now. Take a screenshot. And they are solving right now some exercises. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Look at this. We're using forms of have to. And it could be have to, has to, don't have to, doesn't have to. Okay. It would depend.
Okay.
Okay. Very well. We're working with Leida, Emerson, and Maria for this. And if you have questions, let me know, okay?
Okay.
Para el he también se usa el have.
¿Para?
El he.
Oh, yes, has. He, she, it is has.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I will go to another breakout room. Los Ricardos estarán de oyentes por el momento. Okay. And I'll be back with you. Ya regreso.
No estaba usted ahí presente.
Sí. No puse mucha atención, soy sincero.
¿Usted escuchó?
I'm not surprised.
Claro.
Dígame.
En arroz, usted dijo que no era necesario el has porque iba a dar.
Exacto, exacto. Como estamos utilizando el auxiliar das, no vamos a utilizar, el verbo va a volver a su forma normal. ¿Verdad? Entonces. cuando estamos teniendo una oración afirmativa, sí tenemos que cambiarlo. Leida has to cook dinner tonight. Leida tiene que cocinar hoy. Leida has to cook dinner tonight. Pero cuando hacemos la negativa, Leida doesn't have to cook dinner. Ahí ya no digo has, sino que digo have. Okay, doesn't have to cook dinner. Porque ya utilicé does. Exacto. Exacto. Okay.
You're welcome.
La tres es, my mother has to go to the office. No.
My mother?
Has to?
Has to go, exactly, has to go. The,
mm-hmm. Le puse, escribir has, porque está hablando de ella.
Exacto. My mother, ¿y cuál sería ella en el pronoun?
She has to.
She has to. Okay. She has to. Excellent. Excellent.
Okay. I have to study for the grammar test tomorrow.
Exactly. Okay, pero vamos a revisarles ahorita todos los demás, okay? Vamos a revisarles okay. Con los demás. Ahorita también la ley. Ok, let's go ahead and check with the others. Vamos a checarlas con los demás. Vamos. Les queda un minuto para que discuta aquí con Emerson y con Leida, que es con los que ha trabajado. Okay, so let's continue. Oh, I only have the two of you. Los demás están trabajando. Let's wait for the others, okay? Esperemos a los demás. Hello.
Okay. Teacher, no la veo.
Que no me va a ver, le estoy diciendo, ya le dije tres veces.
Ok, teacher, voy a ver si me acostumbro a no verla este día.
Que no me va a ver. Today, no me sirve la cámara. Estoy acordando que soy pobre y no he reparado la cámara. No me sirve la cámara.
Está bien, teacher.
Okay, good. Let's continue. Working here. You were supposed
imagination.
To play. Imagination. Imagine my beautiful face. Now, let's see. I am going to share with you again the sentences, right? And you are going to tell me the answers, okay? I am going to start with Concepcion, with number 3. Emerson number 4, okay? Let's just, okay, there we are. Number 3, Concepcion.
My mother has to go to the post office now.
My mother has to go, excellent job. My mother has to go to the post office. Put it here. My mother has to go. My mother has to go to the post office now. Excellent job. And Emerson?
Number 4.
Yep.
I have to study for the grammar test tomorrow.
I have to study for the grammar test tomorrow. Very well. Number 5. Who wants to do number 5? It's question and answer. Who wants to go?
Teacher, can I?
Yes, okay, Carmen, go ahead.
Okay. Do they have to get up early every morning?
Good.
Yes, they.
Yes, they
have. Yes, they have to get up early every morning.
Very good. That is the...
Or, yes, they do.
Yes, they do. Exactly. Because it's a short answer.
It's a short space.
Exactly. Both answers are correct. Okay? I want you to have that clear. Both answers are okay. However, here the system is asking you for short. But both answers are fine. Las dos están correctas. Lo único que estamos pidiendo es solamente la más cortita. Okay? Very well, Carmen. Let's continue with number six. Who has number six? Thank you, Sandra. Sandra? Let's talk about Patrick in number six. Sandra Gladys, Mendez de Barahona.
Ahorita. Patrick has to try to the story. He can take a bus.
He can take a bus. Okay. Now look at the meaning. The meaning of the sentence. Okay. Okay. Now it says Patrick drive to the store. He can take a bus. Okay.
It has to, teacher.
Okay. ¿Por qué it has to?
He.
Okay, por he. Okay. Look. Sí, muy bien. Patrick has to drive to the store. He can take a bus. ¿Interpretemos las oraciones, Sandra?
Patrick tiene que manejar a la tienda.
Ajá. He can take a bus.
Él puede tomar un bus.
Ajá.
O puede abordar un bus.
Ok. Patrick has to drive to the store. He can take a bus. For example, in the past, I used to live near Metro Centro, okay? In the past, I used to live near Metro Centro. So, I have to take the bus because it was near the university, right? I have to take the bus because it was near the university. But I didn't have to take a bus to go to Metro Center because it was very, very close.
Me pierdo, teacher. No la.
Sería. No puede.
Sí, exactly. Pero ¿por qué? ¿Por qué?
Porque son como como una explicación o como dos opciones. Ajá, como dos opciones. Puedo hacer esto, pero también puedo hacer lo otro.
Ajá, pero no le dice pero. En ninguna parte dice no. But.
But. No
le dice en ninguna parte pero. Okay? No le dice pero. Está diciendo, Patrick doesn't have to drive to the store. He can take a bus. No tiene que manejar porque puede tomar el bus. Okay? Patrick.
Entonces, ¿está correcto, has? No, no tendría que ser.
It has to be needed. Doesn't. In this case, Patrick doesn't drive. Patrick doesn't have to drive to the store. He can take a bus. Mm.
Patrick doesn't have to. No puede manejar. Ah, ya.
No, no necesita hacerlo.
No lo entendía.
No necesita hacerlo porque puede tomar un bus. Yo no necesitaba tomar un bus a Metro Centro porque estaba cerca. Pero sí para la universidad. Okay. Now, number seven. Number seven. And I want you to read the sentences, okay? Lean qué quiere decir la oración. No la traducción, porque con la traducción nos confundimos a veces. Bien, ¿cómo es? Alma de doble filo, dice. Let's go with number seven. Pedrina.
Yes, yo tengo...
What do you have?
Hatu.
Okay.
And the Hatu, sí, a doctor. Be counsel.
Have to see a doctor because she isn't feeling well. Now, let me ask you this, Pedrina. Pedrina?
Sí.
And what is and? What subject pronoun is? I, you, we, they, he, she, he, you? What is it?
Es tercera persona. And.
It's third person, okay. And in third person, what do we do in third person?
O sea, entonces va, that's not, that's.
That's not, why that's not? What is and? Let me see, I have an answer here. In the chat, that's not, no.
No.
Porque es negativo. And doesn't have to see a doctor because she isn't feeling well. What is the meaning of isn't feeling well? For example, imagine that you start like, you go to the doctor, right? Because you are not feeling well.
Mm-hmm. Sí. Entonces pierde el sentido de la oración.
What is the meaning? What is the change that I have to make if it's third person singular?
Has to.
Mm-hmm. And has to see a doctor.
Sí, has to. Mm-hmm. Sí, me confundí.
Because she isn't feeling well. Very good.
Sí.
Now, sí. Number eight, Amilcar. Celia, get ready for number nine.
Has to.
Excuse me, I have to answer my phone. Okay. Yes, Isabel?
Le pregunta 7.
Okay, give me a moment. Give me a moment. In this case, Amilka, when I say I, is I third person singular?
No.
No. So we cannot use has, America.
No. Have to sería.
Have to.
O sea, I en primera persona.
Exactly. Very well. Excuse me. I have to answer my phone. Very good. Now let's go back to number seven, Azalia. What's your question?
Lo que pasa es que habíamos puesto en esa need to.
¿Por qué? Si se lo vamos a utilizar.
Esa era la pregunta que teníamos, porque.
Pero si se lo vamos a utilizar have to aquí, ¿sabes?
Pero solamente have to, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Pero no andaba. Ok.
Podríamos utilizarlo. Anna needs to see a doctor because she isn't feeling well. Lo podemos utilizar también. Pero el ejercicio no sé si utilizamos have to.
Okay. Esta era la pregunta, tío. Que sí se puede, pero como el ejercicio no estaba pidiendo have to.
Exacto, ajá. Es cuando le digo yo, su respuesta.
Creo que platicamos.
Cuando le digo, su respuesta es magnífica.
aplica, pero no aplica el ejercicio.
Y eso le va a servir para futuros exámenes, para visas, para becas, para todo, que tienen que responder lo que les piden en el
instructivo. Lo que preguntan.
Aunque su respuesta es excelente, si no pega con la instrucción, se le van a poner mal. Pero sí, yo puedo decir, Ann needs to see a doctor because she's been feeling well.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's go ahead and continue with the next one. Here, number 9, Celia.
Does you have to leave some?
Can I use it? Okay, my question. Is you third person singular, Celia? I want you to have this fear. Let me show you. Se van a perder las respuestas, así que copien las respuestas. Tome un screenshot de las respuestas antes que me mueva de acá, por favor. Tome un screenshot porque se van a perder. Ok.
Ya. Yeah. There you go. No, todavía no.
Leila.
Espéreme.
La pero.
Gracias.
¿Ya?
Sí, ya, yeah, gracias.
Okay, good. I want you to remember this. Y esto me van a hacer planas quizás de tarea. Okay. Me van a hacer planas, todos. Right here. I'm gonna make a line. Okay. No fui a clase de dibujo, así que no me quedé. Now, what do I have here? Right? And this is very simple. Does and do. Porque veo que se me están equivocando demasiado. Demasiado se me están equivocando con algo que ya lo hemos trabajado. Okay? So what do I have here? I have does and I have do, right? I am going to use does with third person singular. What is third person singular? She. He. It. Solamente con eso. No voy a utilizarlo con ningún otro. I am going to use do with I, you, we, okay. ¿Con cuál voy a utilizar la regla de la S? Con third person singular. Solamente acá. Solamente en este. ¿Con estos, teacher? No. ¿Por qué? Porque no. No se puede. La lingüística del idioma inglés no nos permite que utilicemos la regla de la S con I, you, we, and they. Teacher, y cuando utilizo does, ya no utilizo la regla de la S. Exacto. Right? Pero cuando estamos utilizándolo en afirmativos, right? Rule of S is going to be in, oh man. Rule of S is going to be in the affirmative form. Okay, rule of S, affirmative form. Das, y el das, ¿en qué? ¿Para qué? ¿Cómo? ¿Cómo se come? Das, okay, das. What is the use of does? We're going to use it in negative questions. Negative questions and short answers. Okay, and then the rule of does. Y en el do, exactly for the same. We're going to use it for negative questions and short answers. Okay, negative questions and short answers. Para lo mismo. Y la regla es no, para este no. Okay, para este no. Okay, so here we can put rule of rule of S, Silvia? Que no. No. Okay, that's what we're going to do for the use of do and does. Is this part clear? ¿Se entiende este que acabo de hacer? ¿Este relajo que les acabo de decir acá?
Yes, teacher.
¿Entiende?
Yes.
Okay,
yes, teacher.
Okay, Celia, very good. Please copy this information. No le tomen un screenshot de esta información. Copienla, por favor. Copienla. Voy a dar 3 minutos para que la copien. Mentira, copien. Let me know when you finish. Avísenme cuando termine, por favor.
Finish.
Finish, very good.
Finish.
Okay, now that we have finished, ¿ya todos terminaron y todos copiaron? Asumo ese silencio como así. Let's continue. Now we were in number, let's see. We were in number nine. Celia, now what is your answer in number nine?
Do you have to leave soon?
Do you have to leave soon? Excellent job. Very good, Celia. Number 10, Ricardo Gabriel. Ricardo Gabriel, are you there? No? ¿Se fue? Okay, María Concepción, help me out.
Is my friend has to take a drink test this afternoon.
Very good. A driving test. Repeat with me, Concepción. Driving.
Sorry, teacher.
Driving test.
Very good. Now we go with number 11. It's going to be here. Emerson. Then Abigail, number 12. Ricardo Gabriel, number 13.
Okay.
And the number 11. Camels have to drink water for a long time.
Okay, camels have to drink water for a long time. Okay. Once, okay, but what happens with camels? They store, you know, they store water in their backs. They store water in their humps. Okay, so actually they don't. They don't, Emerson. La oración está perfecta, pero en la realidad, they don't have to drink water for a long time. Camels don't have to drink water for a long time. Toman agua y la almacenan en su espalda. Okay? So the answer here, Emerson, is don't have to. Now, number 12, Abigail.
My sister has to see a dentist.
Read the next part. She.
My sister has to.
Yes, my sister has to see a dentist. Veala toda, no solo se queda mal.
Okay. My sister has to see a dentist. She has an appointment.
Excellent. She has an appointment. Very good. Number 13, Gabriel.
Astronauts have to bring food and water into space? No.
One more time. Astronauts. Lean la oración, el contexto de la oración.
Yes. Astronauts don't have bring food and water into space. Don't have to.
Don't have to bring food and water into space. That's correct. Ya lo vi a la pobre con pantalla de agua. No. Astronauts don't have to bring food and water into space. Very well. Carmen, do 14.
14. Does he have to study now? Yes. He does.
Yes, he does. Excellent job. Excellent job. Christine. And Alexis. No, Alexis just joined. Leida. Number 15, Leida.
Espérenme porque no la veo. Y...
Déjeme moverme aquí. Ya, ahora sí.
Espérame, espérame.
La pero, la pero.
Pero es que yo no la veo. Dice,
do you really?
Do you really have to?
Very good. Do you really have to make so much noise? Do you really have to make so much noise? Very well. This practice was amazing. Very good. We practiced a lot. Practicamos un montón. Muy bien. Muy bien. Let's continue. Questions about this exercise? Antes que nos vayamos.
La 14, teacher, no, no me quedó.
Okay. Carmen, repeat the answer.
¿Das? En la 14, teacher.
Yeah, Carmen is...
Yes, it's a question and answer.
Yes.
Hey, does he have to study now? Mm. You use the auxiliary does.
Okay,
and use have because you are using the auxiliary does. Does he have to study now?
Yes, he does.
Yes, he does.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Very well. Thank you, Sylvie. Thank you, Carmen. Thank you, Sandrita. What?
You're welcome.
Do you have any other questions? No? Let's go. Let's talk. Let's talk. I want you to talk. Put your pens down. Ponga su lapicero, su lápiz por allá. Let's talk. Let's think about the answers. Do you mark your events in your calendar? Why? Do you attend every day? Now, what is the meaning of mark? When we say, do you mark your events in the calendar? I am going to show you my calendar, okay? Voy a mostrar mi calendario. No se lo enseñen a nadie. I'm going to show you my calendar. When I mark my events in the calendar, this is my calendar. It looks crazy, but it's not. Se ve loco, pero no está loco. Every day, I mark my activities in my calendar. This is what I have to do. Right? This is what I have to do every day. Right? So I have different activities. I have different things. So I mark them. Right? This is what I do. What about you? Do you mark your activities in your calendar? Oh, January was happy. Okay. Do you mark your activities? ¿Marcan ustedes sus actividades así como yo, que tengo que tener todo si no se me olvida?
Yes, teacher.
Yes.
I do.
Why? Why?
Yes, because I have to organize my shift, for example.
Yes, you have to organize your shift. Very good. You have to
my activities during the shift. Yes.
Your activities during the shift. Very good. What about you, Abigail? Do you mark your activities in your calendar? Mark is like, for example, if I come here and I say, vamos a ver con el calendario. Okay, we are March 12th, and we say March 13th. I'm going to mark an activity tomorrow, class, 9 a.m. Right? I am marking an activity, right? And I'm putting here, right, the time for the class, right? And I'm going to save it, and I'm going to put here, class. Ya marqué la actividad, right? Do you mark your activities, Azalea?
Solamente cuando tengo eventos.
Okay, in English, how can you say that? Only?
No sé cómo se dice. Only events.
Only when I have events.
Only when I have events.
Very good. Only when I have events. Very good. Very good. What else? What else? Do you mark your activities, Maria Concepcion?
Only when I have to my period.
Okay, and do you attend every event or every activity? In my case, I have to attend every activity. That's it. No, no falta la actividad. Okay, I have to attend every activity. Teacher. What about you? Yes?
Teacher, in my case, I usually mark all my activities because other people can see my calendar and ask me for some meeting or make an appointment, so they can see my availability in the calendar because it's a company calendar.
Oh, that's tricky. Okay, yeah, that's dangerous. That's dangerous. Yes, I have another job.
Yes, yes. They don't see the name of the activity, but they can see the block of activities.
The block of activities that you are busy. Exactly.
Yes.
Good. Exactly. Very good. So we have there different activities that we can. Mark, what about the others? Tell me more. Quiero escucharlos. Quiero escucharlos intentar hablar. Sandra.
I mark activity in the calendar when pay tax and they meet him.
Okay, very good. Very good. And do you attend those events, Sandrita?
Hi.
Do you attend all the events? Do you attend all the activities?
Yes.
Excellent job. Okay, you attend all the activities, very well. Now, tell me here, choose another person, Sandrita. Oh, otra persona que me responda aquí. Coge otra persona, Sandrita. Choose another person.
Ahorita.
Aquí está más distraído, ¿bien?
Celia.
Celia. Ay, por qué. Okay. Let's talk, people, let's talk. Intentemos equivocarnos porque solo así vamos a aprender. Bueno. Celia,
my program calendar, my activities, for example, meeting, solamente, yo solamente.
Okay, I program activities, and program is another, you know, it's another word that we can use, I program. Cuando decimos mark, es agendar, programar, y la otra palabra, sinónimo de agendar, de program, is mark, okay, program, program. Right? These are examples of that, right? Program, mark, schedule. Son palabras que ustedes pueden utilizar. In my other calendar, in Google Calendar, it says mark, right? Or create. Create an activity. In other calendar I have, it says schedule an activity. Schedule an activity. Okay, now let's continue. Let's continue. Next activity here that we're going to do, it's pronunciation time. We're going just to practice with pronunciation. I want you to look at the conversation, okay? Once we look at the conversation here, we're going to see, first listen to me, and then you're going to practice right now individually, right now here. Okay, aquí vamos a practicar. And once you have practiced, I'm going to ask you, Concepción in America, let's start. And you are going to practice. Voy a escoger tres equipos, tres parejas, para que practiquen. Okay? Listen to me carefully. Susan. Adele, please check my agenda. When is the meeting with the consultant? On Monday, November 22nd. What about the conference with the Mexican representatives? It's on Friday the 26th. One more time. Adele, please check my agenda. When is the meeting with the consultant? On Monday, November 22nd. What about the conference with the Mexican representatives? It's on Friday the 26th. It's on Friday the 26th. Now, let's practice right now the pronunciation of this conversation. I will give you 2 minutes, 2 minutes to practice. And tell me if you want me to pronounce a specific words. Si quieren que les diga la pronunciación de palabras específicas. No se duerma, Mirta. Tome café, tome café. El café pira. Let's drink coffee. Now, this conversation is on your book, by the way, but I forgot the page. I think it's on page 20 something. Ya le digo en qué página está. Si no me gana, Salia. Está en su libro.
28.
28. Thank you so much. It's on page 28. Está en la página 28. Okay, it's on page 28. Ricardo, wake up. Ricardo David, wake up, wake up, wake up. Wake up. Add a stretching. Exactly. Add a stretching. En la página 28. Okay, we practice pronunciation. Are we ready right now? ¿Ya practicaron? Yo creo que sí, yo no lo veo hablando, solo lo veo viendo en la pantalla. Entonces me imagino que ya le practicaron la pronunciación en su mente.
A buscar la página, teacher. Okay.
No la veo, teacher.
Ok. Recuérdense que eso es como cantar en su mente. Okay, exacto. 28. No me ve, no me va a ver, ya le dije.
Eso no me concentro, teacher.
¿Crees que no me concentro cuando me mira? Sí. ¿Sí, Alexis? ¿Sí, Alexis?
28, pero teacher, 28.
28. Dígame,
Alexis.
¿Ah?
Representative.
Representative. Repeat with me. Representative.
Representative.
Representative. Así se llaman casi todos los de servicio al cliente en los call centers. Customer Service Representative.
Y solo la vamos a leer, teacher.
Ahorita sí. Ahorita sí. Quiero. Dice ahí, pronunciation time.
Personal.
Sí, ahorita sí, porque ya le voy a decir yo, fulanita con fulanita, fulanito con su tanguito. Right. 1 minute, 1 more minute, 1 minuto más. Esto es bien chiche para ustedes.
Teacher 22ND, ¿cómo se pronuncia?
20 seconds.
Excuse me.
20 seconds.
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome.
Teacher.
Yes, Alexis.
Agenda. ¿Cómo lo voy a pronunciar?
Agenda.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Teacher 26, ¿cómo lo pronuncio?
26.
No. No la veo, teacher.
La voy a poner en mi pieza.
26.
Escúcheme, por la voy a poner en
Okay.
26.
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Okay, are we ready? I think we're ready. Let's see. I'm going to listen right now. I'm going to listen. I want to listen to Emerson. I want to listen to Maria Concepcion. Okay, I'm going to share the screen one more time with the conversation. Right? And Emerson, you are Susan. Maria Concepcion, you are Adele.
Okay. Adele, let's check my agenda. When is the meeting with the consultant?
On Monday, November 22nd.
What about the conference with the Mexican representatives?
It's on Friday, the 26th.
It's on Friday, the 26th. Excellent job, you two. Very good job. Excellent. Good pronunciation, both. Very nice. Now I want to listen to Sandra Gladys and I want to listen to Ricardo Gabriel.
Yes, Freddy.
Okay.
I'm Susan or Adele?
You are Susan, she's Adele.
Okay, Adele, please check my agenda. When is the meeting with the council?
On Monday, November 22nd.
What about the conference with the Mexican representative?
It's on Friday, the 26th.
On Friday, the 26th. It's on Friday, the 26th. It's on. It's on. It's on. Repítalo, así.
It's on.
Exacto. Esas dos palabras, únalas y hágala una sola. It's on.
It's on.
It's on Friday, the 26th. Very good. Cuando vayamos practicando más pronunciación, se van a fijar que las palabras se van uniendo. ¿Ok? No decimos, please check my agenda. Please check my agenda. Please check my agenda. So, when is the meeting with the consultant? When is? When is? No decimos, when is the meeting with the... No. When is the meeting with the consultant? And I want two more. Dos más. Let's see. Alexis?
Yes, yes, yes.
And let's see here, Azalia.
Sanadora.
Susan is going to be, you're going to be Susan, Azalia. Adele is going to be Alexis.
Okay. Adele, please check my agenda. When is the meeting? The meeting with the consultant.
On Monday, November 22nd.
What about the conference with the Mexican representative?
It's on Friday, day 26th.
Okay, 26th. Very good. Azalia, repeat with me. With the consultant. With the consultant.
With the consultant.
Okay, with.
With.
No, no with. With.
With.
Cuando usted dice la palabra with, en esta palabra, al final no sale el sonido de la T. Lo que sale un airecito. With.
With the consultant.
No, with me está diciendo David. With. Y es aquí es con, la conjunción con. Entonces, with va a poner, déjeme, usted no me puede ver, pero yo sí la puedo ver. Va a poner la punta de la lengua cuando termina la palabra en medio de, sus dientes inferiores y superiores y va a sacar un poquito de aire. With.
With.
Ahí está.
Como que fuera con G, teacher. Como que fuera con G.
Con una D suave. With.
Algo así, pero más con un sonidito de aire. With.
With. With.
Exacto. With
the consultant.
Sí, la T me la hace más suavecita, por favor. With the consultant.
With the consultant.
Ah, you see? Very nice. Now, let's repeat here. Alexis, November 22nd. Alexis.
November. Aquí estoy, teacher. No, November 22nd.
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 Okay, second. Very good. And?
Second.
It's on Friday, the 26th.
It's on Friday, day 26th.
Day 26th, not day. It's on Friday, the 26th.
Day 26th.
Very good. And now, please, Azalia, Mexican.
Mexican.
Mexican representative. Very good.
Mexican.
Now, Mexican. We're going to, yes, Mexican. Mexican. We're going to continue practicing here, guys, and we're going to practice with more pronunciation. The book is telling us that we need to practice the months of the year one more time. The 12 months of the year. Right? The 12 months of the year. First, I am going to make a pronunciation for you. Okay. Listen to me, and then we practice. Okay. First. January.
January.
Okay, only listen right now. Only listen. Right now, only listen. Right, so you can remember the pronunciation. Number one, January. It's not January, no, January. January. February. No es February. 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 March. March.
March.
Listen, only listen. April. April. No April, no, April. April. May. May. June. June. July. July. August. 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 Oh. Oh. August. August? No. Oh. Oh. Así como que están casados. Oh. August. Exacto. No, tampoco, Ricardo. Tampoco. Okay. Now, let's continue. September. 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 October. October. November. 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 Para pronunciar la letra B, right? Esta B, la primera, November, vamos a poner los dientitos de superiores, right? Como no me pueden ver, se lo puede decir en español. Los dientitos superiores, suavecito, los ponemos en los labios inferiores. November. Exacto. La B del final, la última B, la vamos a unir, la vamos a decir con los labios. Ba, ba, uniendo los labios. November. Así hacemos dos sonidos distintos. November. That is the difference. Then we have my favorite month, December. December. Yes, December. We have a lot of parties, right? December. Okay, now, one more time, I am going to, now I want you to please repeat with me. Ahora sí vamos a repetir, ustedes conmigo, okay? A la one, a la two, a la one, two, three, right? January.
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 February.
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 Okay, no es February. February.
February.
February.
February.
March.
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 Good. April.
April. April.
Very good. May.
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 June.
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 June. Very good. July.
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 Very good. Like all July.
July.
Excellent. August.
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 August. August. Very good.
August.
August. Excellent. August. September.
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 September. Very good.
September.
October.
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 November.
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 December.
December.
Very good. So we have the months of the year. Okay? Remember, in each month of the year, we can have important dates. Right? We have important dates. So on January, we have New Year's. Right? We have New Year's Eve on January. On February, we have Valentine's Day.
Time.
On February, we have Valentine's Day. On March, we have
vacation.
Irish Day. Vacation. Irish Day. Okay? Irish Day. Irish celebration. Right now, the holidays I'm giving you are from the United States. Okay? Los holidays es para que tengamos un poquito de cultura de Estados Unidos. En marzo celebran el día de San Patrick. Okay, St. Patrick's Day. I'm gonna write it here. siguiente.
Week.
Saint Patrick's Day. Saint. Oh, sorry. Saint Patrick's. Saint Patrick's Day. Okay, that is the day that we celebrate on March.
A Wednesday. It's a Wednesday.
It's Wednesday.
Yes.
Ah, la, el día, sí. Uh-huh. Idea es específico. It's true. Entonces, los americanos celebran con días, no con fechas. Uh-huh. The Saint Patrick's Day is on a Wednesday. Very good.
La, la Semana Santa.
Eso es en El Salvador. Holy Week.
Holy.
Holy Week.
In El Salvador, we celebrate Holy Week. Let me put it in the chat. Porque no pega Holy Week con la imagen que me puse. Holy Week. Holy Week. Semana Santa.
Okay.
Holy Week. In El Salvador, we celebrate Holy Week. In the United States, we celebrate St. Patrick's Day. Okay? Se bebe cerveza verde, se bebe, se celebra con el dulcito, se celebra con Mardi Gras. Right? Those are the things. Uh-huh. In that?
In the country, celebrate a restaurant and
Benigans. Yes.
Yes.
In Benigans. We celebrate in Benigans. Okay. We go in April. April, we celebrate the day that we all
Pascua.
Pascua
Day. How do we say Pascua Day?
Day Pascua.
How do we say Pascua in English?
Huh? You say.
How do we say Pascua? Pascua, we say it Easter.
Easter.
At Easter. Easter is not the same as the Catholic religion. The Catholic religion, in the Catholic religion, they also celebrate Pascua, but in El Salvador, se celebra la Pascua. Pero en los Estados Unidos es diferente. Tenemos conejitos, vamos usando conejitos con huevitos, right? And they have gifts, they have presents. Let's go with May. What do we celebrate in May?
Day Mother. Day Mother.
Mother's Day. And it's the same in the United States. In the United States, they celebrate Mother's Day. I think it's on the second day of, second Sunday of May. Like Mother's Day, I don't know what. Mother's Day. Let me check. It's the second day of May. Second Sunday. No es el 10 de mayo que lo celebran.
Diferente.
Yes. June. What do we have in June in the United States? A spring break.
My happy birthday.
Your birthday. We have it. In El Salvador, we have Father's Day. In the United States, the celebration is spring break. A spring break es cuando todos los estudiantes de los Estados Unidos. All the students from the United States, they are supuestamente
teacher day.
They go to, yes, pero en Estados Unidos, Azalea, we call it a spring break, with when all the students, they go to the beach. They go to the beach for vacation. Yes. So if you go, if you travel in June, si piensan viajar en junio, no vayan a la playa. It's going to be full of students, full of teenagers. Debe estar lleno de estudiantes, universitarios y high school people. ¿Ok? No vayan, no pueden. Si tienen pensado viajar. ¿Ok? In El Salvador, we celebrate Teacher's Day. We celebrate Father's Day.
Father's Day. Right?
Yes. But here in the United States, it's totally different. We also have July. What do we celebrate
teacher,
on July?
Teacher, in the spring, the students that go to the... bilingual classes in El Salvador have to the break or finish or the end of the scholar year.
Yes.
To college in the country.
Yes, we have. I work in another school, and that we're going to finish in June. Yes, we're gonna have vacation. Vamos a tener vacaciones en junio porque terminamos el año escolar. Right? There are many bilingual schools in El Salvador that they finish their school year in
October.
In June. Very good comment, Carmen. And then we have July. July is for
Independence Day.
Independence Day. Independence Day is on July 4th. Right? Ese sí tiene fecha. Right? July
4th.
July 4th. Right? That is Independence Day in the United States. Right? Independence Day. Esta es cultura, chicos. Tenemos que saber de los Estados Unidos. Y vamos a hablar inglés. Okay. July 4th, Independence Day. Right? Día de la Independencia Patria. And what is the Independence Day in El Salvador? When is the Independence Day?
On
September 15th. Very good. Very good. On September 15th. We have August. What do we have in August in the United States? Look at the stars. What do we have? What do you think we have?
Fall. Fall?
Yes. No, the fall is actually around November. Right? Okay. It's around November. In the United States, right? In the United States, in August, we have different celebrations, but they are not big celebrations. No son celebraciones así como que grandes. I think just celebrations like, you know, American people, they celebrate a lot of things. For example, they celebrate International Cat Day. No, they celebrate International Cat Day. They celebrate International Watermelon Day, right? Watermelon Day, you know, watermelons and these. They celebrate that. That's on August the 3rd. They also celebrate National Ice Cream Sandwich Day. Imagine, they are crazy. Right? So they have a lot of amazing, amazing days. My favorite one is National S'mores Day. And I'm gonna show you what a s'more is, okay? National S'mores Day. Because this is what people do when they go camping. National S'mores Day. Si usted va a los Estados Unidos y va con personas americanas, they want to get you to go to a camping, okay? To a place, a acampar, así como que fuera al hospital, right? And they are going to give you s'mores. They talk about a lot about s'mores. These are s'mores. Let me show you. These are s'mores. Oops, this picture is too big. These are s'mores. These are marshmallows. You know marshmallows? Marshmallows that you can cook on a bonfire. Los cocinan en las fogatas. They put marshmallows on a bonfire, and we have National S'mores Day on August. National S'mores Day. And then we have September, right? When we start working with the fall, right? And then we have October, my favorite, Halloween, right? Halloween Day. Then we have November with Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving. In El Salvador, like Carmen was saying, there are many bilingual companies. They celebrate Thanksgiving. For example, In call centers, they celebrate a lot October with Halloween, right?
Halloween
and Thanksgiving. Esto se celebra en toda compañía o institución bilingüe. Se celebran esos días. Es un must. Es un have to. They have to celebrate this too. Then we have this
October Plenty is celebrating.
Oh, yes, October Plenty is also for, but this is for the British culture, Carmen. October Plenty es para la cultura británica. Muy bueno, sí. Pero reciben toda la entrada del otoño de la, para celebrarla con alegría. Porque los paisajes son hermosos. So, they celebrate October Plenty. That's true. But that is in the British culture.
Black Friday.
Black, yeah. Yes.
Black Friday.
Black Friday is a celebration now.
Yo no es el comercial, yo solo dije Black Friday.
Prado, la curación, vengan a comprarme. Okay. And December is for Christmas, right? When is Christmas here in El Salvador? ¿Cuándo es Christmas en El Salvador?
24.
On the 24th. We celebrate Christmas on the 24th. But in the United States, they celebrate Christmas on the 25th. 25th of December, yes. 25th. That's the day that they celebrate Christmas. No matter what, ellos no hacen nada el 24. Ellos celebran el 25. Right? Now, let's go ahead and...
Nosotros el nacimiento de Jesús.
They not celebrate... The one?
New Year's
Eve,
pero eso ya era en enero. ¿Y se lo dejamos acá? New Year's 31 Eve.
De diciembre.
New Year's, ellos no celebran el 31, solo los latinos lo hacemos. Okay. New Year's Eve. Aquí sería New Year's. Y acá sería, podríamos celebrar. New Year's Eve on the 31st, el 31. Pero eso es aquí en el país. Okay, very good. So we have there for celebration. Now let's practice with something that my friend there was asking, right, about the different activities. But let's practice here. Let's practice ordinal numbers, okay? Ordinal numbers with pronunciation, because we have ordinal numbers and we have cardinal numbers. What are cardinal numbers? The cardinal numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, right? Esos son los números cardinales, cardinal numbers. But right now, porque yo sé que se pueden los cardinales, we are going to practice ordinal numbers, and we're going to practice the pronunciation of this. I want you to please listen to me so we can practice pronunciation. We're going to start here. First.
Second.
Third. Acá no es fierce, porque muchos decimos fierce es first, second, third. Ahora viene lo bonito. Fourth.
Fifth.
No, tick. Tick es otra cosa. Tick es como usualmente se utiliza para una mujer que no es delgada y no es gorda. That is tick. Okay. Ahorita estamos con
fifth.
Ahora vamos con la siguiente.
Sixth.
Seventh.
Seven.
Eight. Nine. Okay, escuchen. Nine. Ten. Very good. These are the first numbers, okay? Let's go ahead and practice. We have more here. Can you see my screen?
Yeah. Okay.
Yes.
Now, we have here the pronunciation. Look at from 11th to 20th. Okay. 11.
11.
14. Okay. Me están diciendo los cardinales, me están diciendo 14. No me están pronunciando la TH.
Es
14. Teacher. Okay, listen to me again. Vamos a hacer lo mismo que hicimos con Azalea. La TH. Todos, y déjenme ver acá. Yo no los puedo, ustedes no me ven, pero yo sí los puedo ver a ustedes. Así que vamos a hacer lo siguiente. Turn on your cameras. Turn on your cameras, please. Tienen sus camaritas, perfecto. Ok, ahora vamos para hacer la pronunciación de el TH en fourth. Vamos a poner la puntita de la lengua.
Fourth.
Ok, la puntita de la lengua, así como lo hizo Salia, en medio de los dientes inferiores y superior, ¿ok? Y vamos a hacer el sonido que sea así, este sonido. ¿Escuchan? Como que va a escupir, pero no va a escupir un niño de 4 años. Exacto. Va a salir un poquito de aire. Si no sale aire, no está pronunciando bien. No lo veo pronunciando. No lo veo, no veo a Abigail, no veo a Emerson. Solamente el sonido quiero que me hagan. Ok, bueno, como no lo vamos a hacer, quiero ver, Carmen, you go first.
11.
No, solo el sonido.
Up.
Ok. Menos zumbidito. Más airecito. Ok, ahí vamos. Celia, Carmen, no es cierto. Celia. ¿Cómo sigue? Nadie la va a criticar, todos estamos aprendiendo. Y si la critican, ahí me cuentan. Le bajamos 5 puntos. ¿Ah? Cilia, haga el sonido. Ya, creo que chévere.
Se escucha.
Ok. 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 Leida. No, no enrolla la lengua. Ponga la puntita de la lengua entre los dientes. La punta de la lengua. Enséñame la punta de la lengua. Ahí. Vaya, ahora. Haga como que va a sacar aire. Siempre manteniendo la punta de la lengua ahí. No oigo yo el sonido. Exacto. ¿Quién dijo eso? Ok, very good. Fue Leida. Ok, Ricardo. Para que se deje estar viendo. Ajá. Miremos a Ricardo, ajá. No le escuchamos.
No se escucha, expulsó muy poco aire.
Ok, we need to do this sound. Can you listen to me,
Por
sound?
Por favor.
Ok. Angie. Ni está haciendo el ruido, no está haciendo nada. Angie.
Yes, teacher.
¿No?
No se escucha, teacher.
Hágalo el sonido, quiero ver cómo pone su lengua en la parte de la boca para ver que lo estamos haciendo bien. Ajá. Quítese la mano de ahí. Qué pena. Nadie la va a criticar. Ok. Ajá. Good. Alexis. Then Abigail, get ready. Emerson, get ready. Amilcar, YouTube, quítese la mascarilla un ratito, Daniel. Alexis. Alexis.
Teacher, aquí estoy, ya le hice.
Ya le hice, no he hecho nada. Ajá. ¿No? ¿De qué? Nos aplicó la del internet de este muchacho. Okay,
sorry, teacher. Sorry, I have a question. Do we have an exam today?
El midterm, sí, ya tienen que realizar. Yeah.
Okay.
Uy, llevamos casi sobre tiempo. Okay. Let's see, Abigail. No lo escuchamos por el internet, Abigail. Abigail?
Hi, teacher.
¿Go?
No le escucha.
No sé, pero ni si le ha hecho. Ustedes vieron que le hizo, yo no le vi que le hizo nada. Mire, Sandrita está preparando hasta con agua ya. Ok, good. Sandrita, and then Emerson.
¿Cómo es que ella le escuchó y a mí no?
No, si no le escuché, solo la vi que lo hizo. Ok, Sandra. Cassandra bailando. Emerson. Ajá, exactly. Very good. Do it again. Okay, very good. You listen to him. Very good. Soft and nice. Very good, Emerson. Azalia, usted ya tiene máster en hacer ese sonido porque ya lo hicimos antes. Go ahead. Si se equivoca, 5 puntos menos en el partido. I'm kidding. No, I'm not going to do that.
It's your moment.
Tengo que pronunciar ahorita.
Sí.
Y que no. 11th.
Okay, only the sound. 11th.
11th.
Okay, menos T, Azalia. Menos T. 11th.
11th.
11th. Okay, let's practice. 11th.
11th.
Okay, very good. Pedrina, you're the last one. Concepción. Only the sound. Solo el sonido.
Me escucha, teacher.
Teacher.
Okay, no está haciendo nada.
Teacher, can you see? Can you see 12?
12.
Again?
Okay. 12. And if you look at this, the numbers, the only ones that are different are first, second, third. 12, totally different. But then, when we go to here, from 21 to 30, 21st, 22nd, 23rd, 24th, 25th, it's the same. It's the same here, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Okay. Very good. Those are the phrases that we're going to use. The ordinal numbers. Please take a screenshot. Tomen un screenshot. Y luego le ponen acá los números que le hacen falta. Ahí espacios en blanco. You have to fill in the blanks. Once you have fill in the blanks, right, it's going to be better. Here I need to put a third. Here 7. Y fíjense cómo vamos a hacer los números ordinales para las fechas. Cuando estemos, no queremos escribir la palabra, pero vamos a escribir el número, tenemos que poner las dos últimas letras de la palabra. Okay? And first, ponemos SP. In second, we write ND. In third, we write RD. In fourth, TA. Fifth, TH. This is applicable only with dates. Okay? Only with dates. Nada más que eso. Solamente con fechas. Okay? only with the date. Now, we have here, and we're going to continue with this. This is going to be a practice that we're going to do. If it says March 12th, what do I have to say here? How do you say this in English, Carmen?
April 11th.
April 11th, okay. Let's I, April.
April.
April 11th.
April
11th. Entre una E y una I, okay. April 11th.
April.
Mm-hmm. April.
There is a movie where the guy says April. Okay. April 11th. April 11th. Number three, Ricardo.
January
16. Excellent job. And let's continue with Azalea. What would you do in number four?
February 9th.
February 9th.
February
9th. Very good. And Concepcion, number five.
October 1st.
October 1st. Very good. No diga first, diga first.
First.
Composición, first.
First.
Exactly, October 1st.
October 1st.
Excellent, very good, very good. Now let's go with number six, Pedrina.
May 22nd.
Second. No, okay, no es una Z al inicio, es una S. May 22nd.
May 22nd.
Okay, good, good. Seven, please, let's go, Leida.
July 3rd.
July 3rd.
Third.
Exactly, very good. And number eight, Emerson. This is difficult, I'm sorry.
August 13th.
Oh, 13 es 13. Aquí está, mira, se lo voy a poner solo porque es difícil y quiero la pronunciación. 13. 30.
30th.
Repeat everyone, August 30th. 30. Aquí está, mire, era número 3. Aquí dice August 30th. 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 Please repeat.
August 30th.
30th, no, es más sucio. 30th. 30th. Okay, don't worry. We're going to keep practicing. Please, Alejandro. Now, let's go and, ya son las 10, rapidito, attendance antes que se vaya, y creo que me quedo con una persona al final. Let's go with the attendance very quick. Ana Gabriela Córdoba. Ángela de Jesús.
Presente.
Azalea Melanie.
Present.
Carmen Lizeth.
Present.
Celia Jazmín.
Present.
Daniela Milka.
Present.
Emerson Javier. Juan Josué Hernández.
Present.
Thank you. José Alfonso Palma. Leida Azucena. Luis Armando Ventura. Present. María Concepción Cerón.
Present.
Pedrina Iliana.
Present.
Ricardo Alexis. Ricardo Gabriel.
I'm here.
Roxana Yanira. Sandra Gladys.
Present.
Jennifer Abidei.
Present.
Wonderful job. Now, guys, I need you to disconnect. I am going to stay with one person at the end of this class. I think that person is Leida, if I'm not mistaken. Right? Now, everyone else, have a beautiful night.
Bye, teacher. Today is...
Bye, teacher.
Today is...
Roxana Mengíbar.
Today is...
Oh, my...
Okay, today is Roxana Mengíbar. Roxana Mengíbar no está. No sé si alguien se quiere quedar en vez de Roxana Mengíbar. ¿Nadie?
Yes. Hey, teacher.
Okay, Azalia y Alexis. Okay, very
good.
Good night.
Bye-bye,
everyone. Solo me quedo con Azalia y Alexis.
Have
a nice day. Have a nice weekend. Okay, just give me 1 minute, okay? Deme un minuto.
Alexis.
Hello.
Hi.
¿Cómo está?
Aquí con muchas dudas.
Yeah, estamos igual.
Me pregunto usted primero.
Pues en realidad... Como viene tarde, no sé.
Ah, por eso.
Sí, solo que me repita lo que hicieron.
Utilizamos el do y el das. Se hicieron oraciones. Se contestaron question. Quiero ver. También practice pronouns. Practicamos pronunciación. Ah, la página 28 ya la vio.
Sí, sí, alcancé a verlo.
Ajá. En eso y las... Los meses del año, los días.
Ese sí lo que se ve.
Ajá. Y los números cardinales.
Ah, sí. Yes.
Estamos, ajá. Y solo una vez nos puso a hacer un grupo de...
Hello, ¿cómo
estamos?
Hi. Dígame qué preguntitas tenemos, algún comentario. Empecemos con Alexis.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, ¿preguntas?
No, solo quería como un, digamos, un medio resumen del inicio, como no me conecté, no pude por el trabajo, entonces quería medio saber.
Ah, ok. En el inicio, Alexis, estuvimos trabajando con las oraciones de ayer. Estuvimos recapitulando las oraciones de have to. Que tenían que llevar, por ejemplo, I have to go to the doctor tomorrow at 9 a.m. Okay. Oraciones con I have to. Esas fueron las que estuvimos practicando al inicio de la clase.
Ah, ok.
Sí. Yes.
I have to. Quiero ver, no me quiero ver. Bueno, eso creo que las terminé. Otra cosa que quería consultar es con lo de where do y what time.
When we're going to use.
Y el otro, where do you, que no me habían quedado muy claro porque no mucho lo entendí. ¿Sí?
No, continúa.
Ok. Lo he medio asociado en el aspecto de la oración. Que when do you significa cuando tú. La siguiente es a qué horas tú y dónde tú, ¿verdad? Entonces, a lo que me logré captar es que la oración tiene que llevar como un enlace con estas tres palabras. Al formularlas.
Exacto.
Ok. Sí, que eso no me había...
Se tiene que recordar que when es para preguntar durante un periodo de tiempo.
no significa literalmente cuándo, sino que es en qué periodo de tiempo se va a realizar esa acción. O se está realizando esa acción. Where es para lugar. ¿Ok?
Lugar.
Sí, where es para lugar. And then we have lugar. Also where.
El otro obvio.
¿Cómo?
Ajá. El otro. La no otra, la verdad.
No lo entiendo, Alexis, se le está cortando. Se le cortó algo. Sí,
escriba.
Escríbalo porque no lo entiendo.
Ahorita ya está activado.
Ok. In the meantime, Masalia, tell me your questions.
Dejó homework, ¿verdad? De los number cardinal.
Pero solamente practicar.
Ok.
Solamente practicar, más que todo la pronunciación, y practicar, llenar los que están en blanco para recordarnos cómo vamos a escribir también los números. Si no lo queremos escribir la palabra completa, por ejemplo, no queremos escribir first, no queremos escribir first, vamos a escribir first. Que es como una forma contractada,
eso.
Ajá. Y vamos a preguntar.
Ok, eso sí. Ah, ok, sí, eso no lo entendía muy bien, pero después, cuando ya lo pronunció ahí. Sí, es que como tengo que estudiarlo para aprendérmelo bien.
Sí, sí, claro, no se preocupe. Y en este caso, si usted se fija.
O sea que ahí es como que fuera abreviado, ¿verdad?
Sí, podríamos decirlo así, que es abreviado la forma numérica. Entonces, en esta anterior. El anterior que hicimos, en esta acá le faltan los cositos, el blanco. Usted lo llena para practicar que cada uno de estos va a terminar en las últimas dos letras de la palabra. Mira aquí 21st, no termina en TI, sino que en ST. 21st. 23rd termina en RD. 23rd. Y 22nd, ¿cómo terminaría aquí?
20, ST.
¿Por qué ST? Dice 22nd. ND. Exacto. ND.
Lo último, es lo último.
¿Verdad? Las últimas dos letras. Las últimas
22nd.
Dos letras.
Ah, ahí está. Ya. 22nd.
Exacto. Okay. Very good. Another question, let me know.
No, esa era mi bastante duda que tenía. Pero también tengo que estudiar lo que es el has to y el
have to.
También.
Todos son pronunciación to.
Sí, has to y have to.
Exacto.
Con las negative. Ajá.
Okay.
Solamente teacher.
Doesn't have to and doesn't have to and don't have to. Ok, ¿se entendió hoy la explicación cuando se utiliza el does and do, ¿sale? En la whiteboard, esta explicación.
Yes.
¿Está bien? Okay.
Sí. Sí, porque ahí me confundía yo la primera vez, decía yo que I she he it. Pero es solamente she, he, it.
Exacto.
Y en el do es que se va a utilizar el I. Hasta que horas tenemos para entregar las tareas, teacher. Porque...
Hasta hoy a las 12.
Hoy a las 12, ok.
Sí, pues el tiempo.
Ok, por el tiempo no las he podido terminar, pero hoy las termino.
Very well. Any other questions? Solamente. ¿Y usted, Alexis? ¿Alguna otra pregunta?
Yes, todo bien, teacher.
Ok. Bueno, chicos, entonces ha sido un placer. Pasen muy buena noche.
y disfruten su fin de semana. Hagan el examen, por favor. Déjenlo ya hecho.
Sí, gracias, teacher.
Good. Have a beautiful night.
Good night. Bye-bye. Good night, Alexi.
Good night.
Bye.
Thank you.